Yekwaso began her presidential journey with a checkup on the national football team she trains, training for the Netball World Cup at Treasure Life Center, Kamocha.
The reason why I came to visit the girls today, I just wanted to see, there are like three or four things. One of them, they have never seen me as the president. They've always known me as the vice president. So they had never seen me as the president. Therefore, I had to come to them to present myself. But there is also a lot that has been going on. Someone needed to tell them, someone needed to talk to them. They needed to hear from the horse's mouth what is going on. Therefore, that is another reason why I came to visit them the TLC where they are doing their training. The other reason why I had to come is also to see for myself, how they are, to hear from them how they are doing, to see the conditions under which they are training. So all those combined compelled me to really come and find them here.
After an interaction with the team, Biekwaso immediately dismissed the allegations that players were mistreated.
Contrary to what has been going on in the media, the picture that they've been trying to paint, some people are saying now the girls' morale is low, the girls, this thing is affecting netball. Contrary to that, what I've discovered is, and from the mouth of the girls, they are saying, one, and this is I heard from them, they are saying they have no issues. They haven't been affected with all what is going on. The entire team is here, except for only one person who had a minor problem. All the 26 girls were here. So that shows you that for them, they haven't been affected at all. They were telling me their morale is high. I've been told they told me their welfare is okay, and they are highly gearing up.
Biekwaso was appointed as the acting England Netball Federation president following the sidelining of UNF president Sarah Vietio on allegations of failing to account for public funds. In her 3 months as the UNF president, Biekwaso has highlighted that the Netball World Cup is the priority.
I'm not coming. This is a federation that is running. And we have a work plan that started at the beginning of financial year. So I'm not coming to change anything. No, the president, Babile Chitosala, is still the president. He's only on leave. So while he's on leave, I cannot begin changing things around. No, I'm only here. And actually, the most important thing in this plan for these 3 months are preparations for participating in the World Cup. That is where all our focus is. All of us are focusing on taking ship friends to South Africa and winning. Yes, bringing back the gold medal. Why not?
Previously, there have been complaints from Uganda Netball Federation President Sarah Vietio that they aren't funded by the National Council of Sports. Biekwaso has confirmed that NCS is to give the federation money for the Netball World Cup.
Ministry of Education and Sports. We want to thank the minister. We want to thank the Honorable State Minister for Sports. But we also want to thank the National Council of Sports, who has told us that our money, 968 million for preparations, but also other administrative issues, is available, only waiting for us to take our budget and work plan for them to be able to release it.
The national netball team, She Cranes, is preparing for the Netball World Cup slated for July 28th to 6th August.